This is so funny because I don't think I've ever had like a sit down, talking video. But I thought I needed to because it's fall. It's fall. It's fall, baby. I had to do it. I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know for fall. I wrote a little list. Also, I did not upload last week because I was not feeling good. I'm still even a little stuffy right now. Starting with some activities you can do. I did this one today. It was quite fun. This morning we went and got some coffee. I got a maple caramel latte. And then we hit TJ Maxx. TJ Maxx is such a fall store. They have such good stuff for fall. And just like smells like fall, kind of. Kind of like musty, like apple-y smelling. You can also go to Barnes & Noble and Bath & Body Works. Oh! I dropped my list, which is also my phone. Something else you can do is go to a pumpkin patch. Now, I have not been to the pumpkin patch in my town since I was like 5. And that's because it's kind of boring. But it's cute for pictures or just like walk around. So that's going on the list too. Go to a pumpkin patch. Moving on to another fall activity is you can host a dinner. I want to do this so badly. I really want to do it outside with like long table and like string lights with soup and bread, which is also another thing on my list is to make soup and bread. I don't know what it is about making homemade soup and bread, but it feels very fall. And I've seen a lot of things on Pinterest, like pumpkin soup. Ooh, if you've ever had pumpkin soup, write it down in the comments and let me know if it's good, because it sounds disgusting. But if someone says it's good, then I'll try making it. And then also make yourself a loaf of homemade bread. Nothing is better than walking into your house and you smell the scent of a fresh loaf of bread being churned and baked. So yeah, do that too. Let's talk movies. Ooh! Music to my ears. If you know me, I am a
huge
movie fanatic. I love movies. That's my favorite thing to do. I will always love watching movies. And nothing can ever take that joy away from me. So let me give you a couple of my favorite fall movies to watch. Up first, we all know it, we all love it. Well, some love it. I love it. And that is Twilight.
Out loud. Say it.
Vampire.
All of them. Watch all of them. All 5. They are peak fall, in my opinion. They're so good, Lee, bad, Lee, awesome. What can I say? Everyone knows the plot. Vampires, werewolves, humans, love triangle. That's basically the synopsis of the movie. You just have the aesthetic scenes and the drama is top tier. And it's just chef's kiss. Twilight, top tier, watch it, love it. Next up, might be something that you would not expect me to say, but they're my all-time favorite movies, and that is The Lord of the Rings.
I will take it.
I will take the ring to Mordor.
These are perfect for any season, as I would say. But especially for fall, just because of the way the movie is filmed and where they filmed, and the shots are just so pretty and perfect, and it's just so good. and they're my favorite movies ever. And the soundtrack, woo! But it's about a hobbit who goes on an adventure to Middle Earth to put a ring into a volcano of fire to destroy it. I don't want to ruin anything because it's just so good. But if you don't know what the Lord of the Rings is about, like, honestly, come on. Come on, you know. You know, come on. You can tell those are my favorite movies ever. Forget Twilight, just watch Lord of the Rings. Next up on my list is a movie called Dan in Real Life.
Window.
I miss you okay, so much, Dad.
She'll see him again soon enough.
That's sweet.
What's sweet? How's that sweet?
It's okay. It's okay. To be that certain to feel so much love.
Love isn't a feeling.
No.
It's an ability.
You are a murderer of love!
This movie is very fall, in my opinion. It's like set during fall time, I believe. It's about a single father who is actually Steve Carell. So, there you go. There's your first sign to watch it, Steve Carell. He's a single father to three girls. And they go to a family reunion at a cabin. He meets a woman, and there's a little drama there. A little love triangle kind of thing happening with his brother. And it's just very good. I always picture like a scene when they're playing football, and it's just so fally. But that is a good movie, and if you've never seen it, write that down on your list. Very funny, very good, very fall. Next movie I'm going to be talking about is You've Got Mail. Now, the first time I watched this movie, I thought it was the most boring thing ever. I couldn't even remember anything that happened. This year, I rewatched it, and it was so good.
Kathleen Kelly. Hello, this is a coincidence. Would you mind if I sat down?
Yes, I would, actually. I'm expecting someone. Thanks.
Pride and Prejudice.
Do you mind?
Now, it's kind of slow-paced, but if you're in the mood for, like, a fall movie, like, maybe while you're, like, folding clothes or, like, making bread, this is the perfect movie to watch because it's just very homey feeling. Now, it's Meg Ryan and Tom Hanks. Those are the two main characters that we have, and they both own bookstores. So they kind of quarrel a bit about the bookstores, and it's just very good. Yeah. Next is a movie entitled School Ties. Now this movie is even older than the last one. It was made in 1992. It has a lot of well-known actors. Brendan Fraser as the main character, Matt Damon, Ben Affleck. I would kind of relate it to Dead Poets Society for the like aesthetics. Basically the plot is that he is Jewish and most of the boys there do not like Jews. And so when they find out that he is Jewish, things happen and it gets a little gnarly, but I believe it's PG. I think this movie's PG. No, just kidding. It's PG-13. It is a little slow pace. I wanted to say something. Oh, yeah, there's a little bit of like back nudity. Like full frontal or full back nudity, so it's kind of a punching scene too, so I don't know, it caught me off guard because I did not remember that. Alright, the last movie that I have for you guys is a movie called Mona Lisa Smile.
Knocks at the door of learning.
I am every woman.
What do you seek?
To awaken my spirit through hard work and dedicate my life to knowledge.
Then you are welcome. All women who seek to follow you can enter here.
Now, this movie also has a lot of well-known actors and actresses in it. The first two that pop up are Julia Roberts and Julia Stiles. The plot of this movie is Julia Roberts is a teacher, so she goes to work for an all-women's college. It's set during the 1950s, so that was a time when basically women were like, the main goal of their life was to get married and have babies. So when Julia Roberts comes in and tries teaching them that there is more to life than that, if they would like, she gets a lot of riffraff from the high up people at the college, but it just gives off all vibes. So that's why I'm suggesting it right now, because it's during college, so college starts in the fall, so bada bing bada boom. It's just a really good movie overall. Now we're gonna discuss some books I need to read for this fall. Now I go in spurts of like liking to read and not liking to read, but I've been on a continuous spurt of liking to purchase books and then not reading them. But this fall we're reading books, and I'm planning on doing a read with me vlog. So if you want to watch that, subscribe, because it's coming, because I have a book right here that I'm going to read during that. Anyways, let's start with the top book here, The Atlas Six. I believe it's very like dark academia. To be honest, I purchased this book because of a YouTuber I watch named Haley Fam, who does a lot of book videos, and I think she watched it read it. I think she read this book. I think it's set at a college where they have like six people have like weird powers, talented magicians, it says in the book, which could be up my alley. But it could not be up my alley. How long is it? 373 pages, which is not, it's not that bad. I could read that. It's just finding the motivation. But if you read this book and you like it, let me know. Or if you hated it, let me know too. But that'll probably determine if I read it or not. But yes, this is the first book that I might read this fall. Up next is The Dance, no, not the, just Dance of Thieves, which I've heard is actually really good if you start it. It's just so thick. That's like half. How long is this book? She's 500 pages. But I've heard that this book is kind of slow, but once you get into it, you really start to like the plot. What is the plot? Okay, well, the back does not really explain what this is about, but I think it's kind of fantasy-ish, but yes, this is on the list. I am forever a stan of Stephanie Garber's The Caraval series, my all-time favorite books. I'll recommend those forever until I find a better book, which has not happened yet, and I read those, I don't know, few years ago. I read all three of them in 2 days. And she is doing like a spin-off series, and I read the first book. It was called Once Upon a Broken Heart. And she just came out with the second book. It's been like a year. Like, I got the last book a year and I read it in a day. And so I had to wait like another year to read this second book. Oh, I'm so excited. But it follows Jax, who is like the Jack of Hearts, or the Prince of Hearts, and then Evangeline, and they kind of are going on a little adventure together. I can't even remember. This is sad. I'm gonna have to like, but this book is not very long, and it's not, well, okay, I say it's not very long because I wish it was longer, but it's like 400 pages, but that's just not long enough. This is the book I'm talking about that I am 100% reading, and I haven't read it yet because I want to film it. I want to film myself reading it for a vlog, so that's why I have not read it yet. But trust me, I've been scratching to read it. I don't know why I said scratching, but whatever. So those are the books that I need to read. Moving on, because maybe you're tired of me talking about books. Let's talk about music. Okay, not that kind of music. If you follow my Spotify, little plug there for you. I never plug my Spotify. I have a fall playlist, fall 2022. It's right here. Very cute. Very good. I'll have the link down in the description too if you want to click on it. But basically, my favorite types of music to listen to, I'd say, is movie soundtracks. No. When I tell people this, they give me weird looks. And they're like, honey, is that a genre? So in this playlist, I have lots of songs from Twilight, Dan in Real Life. I have some Taylor Swift in here. Taylor Swift's 10-minute version, All Too Well, is probably one of the best fall songs that have ever existed. And I will stand by that, no matter what my sister Amanda says. I also love the soundtrack from Lord of the Rings, like I said earlier. Yeah, oh, Gilmore Girls. Got some Gilmore Girls in here. There's some good songs in that. So yeah, I don't talk about music that much because I don't listen to very much music. And if I do, it's like either Christian music or movie soundtracks. And not many people get interested in movie soundtracks, so. Check out the Spotify if you want to see all my suggestions. Let's talk fashion. I don't hop on to all of the fall trends that go around during the times and the seasons and everything. Like, I don't know, I haven't found a good way to wear a sweater vest. Yeah, I do have some suggestions for you. Overall, you can find dupes for everything basically these days. First of all, get yourself a pair of Uggs. Now I have two that I wear literally all the time. They're getting their money's worth. That is my justification for that. But they're just so cute and cozy. And I'm not talking about the tall ones, the short ones. You need the short ones. Next up, still talking about shoes. I do like loafers. I will say that. I don't care if you think they're ugly. I like them. It's hard to come up with an outfit for them, but then I just throw on a skirt and then call it good. And I'm like, wow, this is actually really cute. And you can get really cheap ones at H&M. That's actually where I got my loafers. Next up, okay, still talking with shoes here. I know I'm talking about a lot of shoes, but I like shoes. A pair of cute little booties, a pair of black ones specifically. I think you always need a good black heel booty. For fall, it's just a good staple to have, in my opinion, and they last for a long time. I recently got a pair from TJ Maxx, and I'm excited to style them this fall. Chunky sweaters. Need I say more? I think everyone and their mother knows that chunky sweaters are perfect for fall. There are so many varieties and colors and prices out there. You will basically have no excuse if you don't have a chunky sweater. Going along with chunky sweaters is kind of like chunky crew necks, I guess, or like oversized crew necks. I really like ones with like fall stuff on it. I have a Lord of the Rings one. I know. What a nerd. I like to layer those over dresses and then just throw on a booty or something like that. I think it's super cute and super easy. Jeans. I used to be a really big like mom jean kind of girl, and I still love a good mom jean. I've been liking more of like the baggy look to jeans. I got this one pair from Abercrombie and Fitch, and I've been wearing them all the time. I've been wearing them with like my Uggs and some like, I think it works with the boots too. Mine aren't like as baggy as you can get some of them, but I'm working my way up. I mean, I feel like that's kind of it. I've been talking for like 30 minutes. Those are my fall suggestions. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's differenter than my other videos. So if you literally hate it, let me know. It's been a fun time for me. Even if it hasn't been for you, it's been fun for me. And if you watched this far, I appreciate that. And I appreciate you. And let me know what you're doing this fall. Have an amazing day. And go make yourself a loaf of bread while watching The Lord of the Rings. Alright. Yeah. It's been fun. It's been hard. Have a good one.